Hello, darlings. You've all heard of Marilyn Monroe. Some have been a Bridget Bardot. Well, now it's time for the Cognac Show. I said Cognac, ooh, ooh. I said Cognac, ooh, ooh, ooh. I'm your bubbly blonde, fabulously dressed.
I'm Cognac Wellerlane, and we are here at the third annual North Fork Breast Coalition Pink Gala. Am I right?
The Pink Pearl Gala.
The Pink Pearl Gala. What a fabulous event, and you are doing it now for 3 years. Introduce yourself to the camera.
My name is Susan Ruffini. I am a breast cancer survivor, and I am also the president of the North Fork Breast Health Coalition.
Now tell my audience about the North Fork Breast Coalition. What makes it different from any other breast cancer organization?
What makes us unique is that our main mission is to help anyone who is diagnosed, man or woman, with breast cancer.
It's interesting that you just said men, because men do get breast cancer as well.
Absolutely. And we are here for them. We are here financially, we're here emotionally, we give them support in services and also financial aid, which when you get this diagnosis, the financial burden is large.
Can you tell my audience, if it's okay, could you tell us a little bit about your story, about what happened to you with breast cancer?
Of course, I'm an 11-year survivor.
That's amazing.
And I am very proud of that. I had no lump. I have a very...
You had no lump at all?
At all. I do not have a big family history. I have one aunt. I have a very large family. And I had my one paternal aunt had breast cancer at her, she was diagnosed at age 63. I went for my routine mammograms as always, and they saw something.
But they didn't see a lump?
No, it wasn't a lump, nothing that could be palpated. So after further testing and biopsy, I got my diagnosis of breast cancer.
What was a stage 1 breast cancer?
No, it was actually stage 2B. At the time.
Really? And no lump? That sounds so crazy. I never heard anything like that.
The one thing I've learned with breast cancer, it's not a one-size-fits-all. I mean, I think most people, when they get that diagnosis, this is something that they say, wow, I thought when you had breast cancer, this is what happens, this is how you're treated, this is how you feel.
I've heard people, very unique and individual. I have heard people that do not get lumps, but there's something that isn't quite right with the mammogram, and they actually say it's stage 0. I had a friend that told me that.
Right. Like I said, I felt nothing. They could not feel anything, which made it a little bit more
scarier
or challenging for them to do the surgery. I went through, I had a lumpectomy. They found at that time it had traveled to my lymph nodes, so then I had a axillary node dissection, which was followed by chemotherapy, radiation. And 10 years I'm on hormonal therapy now.
Yes, now they want you to be on for 10 years. Yes, they told me that as well. I'm on Arimidex. I have to take Arimidex for 10 years, which is fine with me. I'm fine with it. I don't care. As long as it's keeping me alive and I don't get cancer again, that's really all I care about.
I agree. I think what was an amazing and a happened for a reason. I have two younger sisters, and they're both diligent with their mammograms also. My one younger sister went for her mammogram normal, sonogram normal, and she had a very, very good doctor who said, you don't have a family history and you have an older sister diagnosed. I want you to have an MRI. And sure enough, my younger sister, a year after I was diagnosed also with breast cancer.
What do you think it is? What's your theory? Do you think it's where we live?
I mean, I grew up in Farmingdale, which was a potato farm. I live in Riverhead on what was a potato farm. Is it environmental? Could be. Is it stress?
Is it pesticides that they're spraying?
Well, they all say we all have cancer cells in our body. Yeah. Some come out, some don't. I really don't know what causes it, but I'm very encouraged and happy that I see so much is happening to detect it early. Having a mammogram early is a wonderful thing, and they act on it quicker, and treatment is not as aggressive as it had to be if it's caught early.
Yeah. Well, I chose to do the radical. I have both my breasts removed. I was terrified. My mother had breast cancer. My grandmother had breast cancer, but nobody died from it. They sort of got it like at the end, a change of life sort of thing. You know, my mother was detected with it when she was like in her 70s. My grandmother was like 80 when they found out she had breast cancer. But I just said, you know what, they found one lump, and never traveled to my lymph nodes. They told me I had stage 1. I said, you know what, just remove both of them and give me bigger ones. So something good came out of something bad. But I'm so happy to hear that, you know, this is a wonderful organization and that you do so much for women out there, encourage and nurture them and make them feel, you know, that it's not the end of the world.
And our community is amazing. I mean, they come out to support us. We have places now coming to us asking if they can have a fundraiser and give us the proceeds, which is just amazing because all the money that we raise stays right here. So we're actually helping our friends, our neighbors, our family members who live right here in our community.
Well, you're doing a terrific job. You look beautiful. Tell my audience where we can go to participate, support, and contribute. What is the website?
You will go to North Fork Breast Health Coalition, and we have a list of our upcoming events. We have testimonials from people that we have helped, and you'll find how to donate to us, how to participate in our, we have a big raffle event coming up in the fall. We have a walk at Tanger the last week in September. So we'd love to see everyone come and support us.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Don't go away yet. We'll be back in a moment, darlings. More interviews coming up. Keep watching. Pink Champagne Kisses. Hello, darlings. Welcome back. I'm Cognac Wellerlane, and we are here at the third annual North Fork Breast Coalition Pink Pearl Gala. I love the name, Pink Pearl. Why Pearl?
So Pearl was our one of our board members, longtime board members, and past president.
Oh.
And Pearl had breast cancer, but surprisingly, she actually died from a brain aneurysm.
Oh my God.
And it was just 3.5 years ago, right before we were about to have our first annual gala. And we didn't really have a name for it. We were batting around ideas of a theme. And with Pearl's passing, we decided to call it the Pink Pearl Gala in her honor.
Well, it's a beautiful name, and I love the way you look, and you did wear your pearls.
Absolutely.
And now you are the event chair. Introduce yourself to the camera.
Sure. Melanie McEvoy, and I'm the Vice President of the North Fork Breast Health Coalition, as well as the gala chair.
Now tell my audience what we are going to look forward to this evening.
Sure. Well, tonight we have our first hour is cocktails. We have a wonderful array of raffle items, which are for sale. And then the dinner is really where we do our awards portion of the evening. It's a celebratory night. We have a lot of survivors in the room. They come here, everybody gets dressed up, has a good time, celebrates why we're here. And then our honorees, of course, are people that are mostly, they're pillars of the community. And,
as you are too, darling, as you are too.
And we're very appreciative of their support. So,
now, I'm not sure, did you also have breast cancer as well?
Yes, I am a 7-year survivor this month.
So when did they detect the breast cancer? How old were you when they detected
it? I was 40. It was my very first.
Young, my God.
It was my very first mammogram.
Oh, God.
Yes. I went into the mammogram feeling very like this is a rite of passage. I was so excited. And I got a phone call the next day saying, you need to come back. And they found something. And
yeah, they never tell you. They just said, we just want to take some more pictures. There's something that doesn't look quite right. We want you to come back. We don't want to alarm you, but we just want you to come back and take more pictures.
They do their best not to panic you, but it's very stressful. And of course, I go in. It's a Friday afternoon. They end up doing 3 biopsies, and I have no idea what's going on. They just sent me up to the 4th floor to go talk to the cancer doctor. And, you know, within...
Crying.
I was just in shock, you know. Within a 2-hour period, you're talking to a cancer specialist. You have no idea what you're going into, and then all of a sudden you have cancer.
Do you have a history of breast cancer in your family?
Nope. No history of it. I'm the first one. Really not a lot of cancer in my family. Certainly not breast cancer.
What was your cancer? Was it stage 1? Was it stage 2?
They found it early, so it was stage 1.
That's me. I was stage 1, too.
So, which is...
Do they find a lump in your breast?
They found 3.
3 lumps?
Yep. 3.
Stage 1, and it was 3 lumps?
Because it had not gone anywhere, and it has been slow growing. It's a type of cancer. It was in 2 different spots. There are 3 different spots, but 2 different types of cancer. And because at the end, I had a mastectomy, and I did not need chemotherapy or radiation. So,
see, with me, and it didn't spread. My mother had breast cancer, my grandmother had breast cancer, but it was stage one, it was a very small lump. And normally they would have not given me chemotherapy or radiation because I told them to take both my breasts off. So I did like, because my mother had it in one breast and then it went to the other breast. My grandmother had it in one breast, it went to the other. Right, so I said, you know what, just take them off and make them bigger and better.
And actually, they do that.
They did.
And my one is so much better than the other one now.
I'm telling you, I look terrific now. I was flat chested my whole life, and now, could you believe this? I got breast cancer to have bigger breasts. Is that the most craziest thing you ever? I never had breasts, and now I have breasts. It's the craziest thing.
One of the some of the lessons that just having breast cancer has taught, I think, almost everybody, but just being grateful and having, you know, getting something positive out of the experience. I feel like a stronger person for it.
The reason why they gave me the chemotherapy was because my onchio score was high. So they felt, because your onchio score is high, this is why we have to give you the chemotherapy.
Yeah, it's based on all kinds of different factors that they look at and lab results. And I did the BRCA test. I don't know if you did the BRCA
test. I did the BRCA test. And this craziest thing also, I don't carry the gene, but yet my mother had it and my grandmother had it. So what does that mean?
And you don't have it, but you had breast cancer. So, and you never know.
Tell my audience what we should all do. I mean, we've heard this, we've read this, it's documented, but you, as a breast cancer survivor, what is your biggest advice? Tell my audience out there.
I mean, obviously, get your mammograms. Don't delay, do it every year. Get them early if you can, because it's striking earlier and earlier. And when breast cancer strikes you and under the age of 40, it's much more aggressive. So,
because you're young, about it. Cells reproduce rapidly.
So go and get that done. Just start doing that process. But most of all, just live, though, and be happy.
And don't be stressed. Don't be stressed out, because that causes cancer, too, you know. I want you to tell my audience, it's very important, I want you to tell my audience where we could go to contribute, donate, and participate. What is the website?
The website is NorthForkBreastHealth.org. NorthForkBreastHealth.org.
Beautiful. You're gorgeous. Don't go away yet. Don't go away. We'll be back in a moment, darlings. More interviews coming up. Keep watching. Pink champagne kisses.
You want a picture?
I was diagnosed in 2008.
2006.
2010. I was 32.
I was 30.
I was only 28 years old when I found out I had breast cancer.
Last year, nearly 200,000 women in the United States were diagnosed with breast cancer.
That means a woman in the U.S. is told she has breast cancer every 2 minutes.
This video is 2 minutes long.
Every woman on the planet is at risk for breast cancer.
And that risk only increases if someone in your family has been diagnosed.
So get checked.
Check yourself.
Perform routine breast exams at least once a month.
It's easy, you can do it in the shower.
If something doesn't feel right,
it's up to you to find out what's wrong.
Tell your doctor about any lumps
or any unusual skin irritation,
itching, or pain.
Get regular mammograms starting by at least age 40 and every year after that.
Breast cancer may not be preventable,
but knowing the facts
and knowing your body
will increase your chances of finding any cancer early.
Early detection means it's easier to treat.
These are your sisters we're talking about.
Mothers, daughters,
friends, neighbors.
Please, stay aware.
Stay healthy.
Stay alive.
I survived breast cancer.
I survived breast cancer.
Sobreviví cáncer en los senos.
I survived breast cancer.
I am still fighting breast cancer.
Talk to your doctor.
Get regular mammograms.
And perform routine self-exams.
It's as easy as taking a shower.
Believe it or not, I never had breast cancer.
I did when I cut off my hair. And I cut off my hair and it was short, I mean literally short, short for 5 years, and I said, that's the longest chemotherapy in history. But everybody thought I had breast cancer. I had two lumps back in from 1993 through 1995. And Antonio, who was taking me over to Southampton Hospital for the biopsies, was asking me all the way over there, what kind of support services are there? Are there support services for men? And I'm saying, I don't know. So about that time, the South Fork Coalition was doing their mapping project, and Antonio went over to the South Fork, and they were doing a press conference on the mapping project to show cancer clusters. And he met Susie Roden, and Susie Roden was the head of the South Fork, or South Coalition. So Antonio said, Ann and I would like to help you out. And she said, if you'd really like to do something, start something on the North Fork, because...
I'm Cognac Wellerlane, and we are here at the third annual North Shore Breast Cancer Coalition's Pink Pearl Gala. And I'm here with the honoree, and she's going to introduce herself to the camera.
I'm Ann Cotten-DeGrasse, and my husband and I formed the North Fork Breast Health Coalition in 1998, and I served as president for approximately 12 years before I bowed out. And so we have been explicitly linked with all of the people that are currently on the board. So I'm very happy to be here tonight and to be honored.
Yes, and to receive this award on your for yourself and your husband.
My husband passed away last April.
Heard about that.
Yes.
Now, your husband wanted to be the founder of this organization.
It's absolutely remarkable the way that it happened. I had two biopsies in my right breast over a period of a five-year time, and he was always asking what kind of support services are there available, and I said, I don't know. And so he went over to the South Shore when they were doing a news release when the South Shore did their mapping project on looking for cancer clusters, and he met Susie Roden, who is the head of the South Fork Coalition, and he said to her, I'd like to do something to help. And she said, if you would like to do something, start something on the North Fork, because there's nothing on the North Fork. So my husband, who was a Rotarian, went to Rotary, and Riverhead Rotary gave them the first $5,000 to incorporate and get all the 501c3 and whatever.
Wow,
and then,
so he made it a nonprofit organization?
Yes, from the very beginning. And then he picked Rotarians that had skill sets. He picked one person that was employed by the hospital, one that was an accountant, one that was an attorney, and several breast cancer survivors, and that's how we got started.
Unbelievable.
So,
and it's been around...
So 1998. So it's been 19 years.
19 years. Your poor husband, he's not even here to accept the award, but you're receiving it in his honor.
Yes, well, I said, you know, there behind every good man, there's a good woman.
Well, he started this because of you.
I didn't have breast cancer, and everybody thought, back in about 95, I told my beautician, I had red hair for a number of years. I told her to take it down. I wasn't going to have two-tone hair. And so she took it down to like a quarter of an inch, and everybody was convinced that I had breast cancer because I cut off my hair. But I never had breast cancer. I just had the two scares where I had the two biopsies. So, yes.
But so you never had the cancer at all?
No.
Oh, okay. Well, I did. I had stage 1 breast cancer. This is one of the reasons why I'm here today. And my story is that, you know, when my mother had breast cancer, my grandmother had breast cancer, so I said, well, and it was on one side, then it came back on the other side with my mother and my grandmother. I said, you know what, just take them both off.
Yeah.
And I said, take them off and give me bigger ones. and they did.
What the Breast Cancer Coalition has done, and the fact that they offer the Linda Helping Hand grants for $1,000, and that they offer services like reflexology and massage therapy, because, you know, 25% of the people that are diagnosed with breast cancer get lymphedema in their lifetime, not always right after the effect either. And they do reflexology, yoga, and the massage therapy and the support groups, which help women get through, along with the financial support.
I want you to tell my audience your advice. Go for your mammograms. Am I right?
Absolutely.
About that? What else can we do? Tell us what we can do.
Pick a time of the year, like your birthday or, you know, your kid's birthday, so that you know that you need to go every time, that time of the year, every year. And also make sure that you go for the clinical exam. More than likely, you can't get the mammogram without having the script from the doctor, but you need to go for the clinical exam also, because sometimes, you know, when you're doing your self-exam, which is very important that you do, but you don't really know what you're looking for. You know, they give you those little packages, little containers where you can feel, and that'll tell you this is what it's going to feel like if you feel something. And I did. I just recently felt something. And so I, when I was going for my mammogram, I said to my doctor, I think there's something there, and it's the same breast that I've had the two other biopsies. So, you know.
Did you ever feel any pain?
No.
Any kind of a funny feeling in your breast?
No.
See, I have pain in my breast.
I have a friend now that's going through it, and she has pain. Yeah.
I had a gnawing feeling.
Yeah.
Tell my audience, where can we go to find out more information, learn more about the North Fork Breast Coalition? Is there a website that we can
yes.
become a volunteer where we can support? What's
yes.
the website?
NFBHC, which is the initials, at optonline.net, and that gives you a phone number to that lets you connect to that. And yes, we'd love to have volunteers that would come and help us out. Everything that we raise goes directly to the people on the North Fork. Nobody gets paid anything.
Well, Cotten, I can call you that, right, Cotten?
Yes,
everybody
can.
Calls you Cotten. I love your name, by the way.
Thank
Cotten.
You.
It's like my name, Cognac.
Kind of from the South, right?
Yeah, I love that name, Cotten. Cotten, you are a gorgeous, fabulous woman, and thank you so much for starting the North Fork Breast Coalition.
Thank you.
Give me a kiss. Okay. Goodbye, darling.
And
we'll be back in a moment, darlings. More interviews coming up. Keep watching Pink Champagne Kisses. Let's toast. Let's toast. We can't leave yet, right?
Hello, darlings. You've all heard of Marilyn Monroe. Some of you know Bridget Fonda.
Been a Crybaby Productions, darlings.